warm wishes to one and all. Myself, my name is Sai Kiran. Today our topic is perfect number. Perfect number. Okay, what is meant by perfect number? Means just here ones are the, okay, I'll take some number. Okay, I'll take some number. For example, I'm taking here 6. Okay, what are the factors of 6? What are the factors of 6 means? 1, 2, 3, 4, sorry, 6. 1, 2, 3, 6. Okay, I'll take another number. Another number I'm taking, okay, 9 I'm taking. 1, 3, 9 are the factors. Okay. When you take the sum of the factor, means when you add the sum of the factor 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 6, okay, 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 6, then what you are getting, okay, it is 12, okay, that is nothing but you can write 2 into 6, you can write on, okay, that means, okay, what is sum of these number factors, 1 plus 3 plus 9, that is what you are getting, 13, okay, 13 is, we can't write in the form of 2 into 9. We can't write in the form of 2 into 9. Just here one of the, what is meant by perfect number means, sum of all factors is equal to, that given number. Or not we need to observe. Sum of all factors is equal to twice the given number or not. Yes, it is twice the given number. Then 6 we can call it as perfect number. Okay, here 6 is a perfect number. Here 9 is not a perfect number. What is perfect number means sum of all factors is equal to twice the given number. Then it is a perfect number. For example, now I am taking another number 28. Okay, what are the factors of 28? Okay, it is divisible by 1 or not? Yes, it is divisible. It is divisible by 2 or not? Yes, it is divisible. It is divisible by 3? It is not divisible by 3. Then 3 is not a factor. Okay, it is divisible by 4 or not? Yes, it is divisible by 4. Okay, is it divisible by 5? Not divisible. Next, it is divisible by 6, not divisible. It is divisible by 7. Yes, it is divisible by 7. 8, it is not divisible. 9, it is not divisible. 10, it is not divisible. Okay, 11, it is not divisible. 12, it is not divisible. Next, 14. Next, 28. Okay, these are the factors. 1, 2, 4, 7, 14, 28. Okay, what are the factors of 28 means, what are the numbers it is divisible, we need to check. Okay, it is divisible by 1, it is divisible by 2, 3 it is not divisible, then it is not a factor. 4 it is divisible, then it is a factor. Next 7 it is divisible, next 14 it is divisible, next 28 it is divisible. Okay, then what are the factors means, 1, 2, 4, 7, 14, 28. Okay, when you add those, okay, 1 plus 2 plus 4 plus 7 plus 14 plus 28, then what you are getting? Okay, when you add the, okay, 7 plus 14, 21, 7 plus 14, 21, 21 plus 4, 25, 25 plus 2, 27, 27 plus 1, 28, 28 plus 28, that is 56, that is nothing but you can write 2 into 28. Okay, just here once of the sum of all the factors is equal to twice the given number. That means 28 is also perfect number. Okay, just here once of the what is meant by perfect number means sum of all the factors is equal to twice the given number. Then that number is perfect number. Here 6 is perfect number, 28 is perfect number. What are the numbers are perfect number? How we can say? Just here once of the one of the formula for that. Just here one of the, what are the numbers are perfect number for that? Just here one of the, what is they are given means 2 power k minus 1 into 2 power k minus 1. Both we can, okay, when we read it as it is same only, but representation is different. Just here one of the, 2 power k minus 1 into 2 power k minus 1. Okay, here minus 1 is, okay, we are subtracted from 2 power k, here 2 power k minus 1. Okay, if this value is prime, when you substitute k value something, okay, this value is prime number, then it is a perfect number. Okay, just we'll check. For example, if I am taking k value 1, we can substitute, then what you are getting? 2 power 1 is 2, 2 minus 1 is 1. Okay, it is not a prime number. Then we are not getting, okay, perfect number. If you take k value 2, That means k value 1 we are taking means we are not getting perfect number. Okay, k value 2 we can take. Okay, k value 2 means 2 power 2. Okay, 2 power 2 is 4, 4 minus 1 is 3. Okay, just here once the 2 power 2 minus 1 into 2 power 2 minus 1. Okay, 2 power 2 means 4, 4 minus 1 is 3. Okay, 3 is prime number. 3 is prime number. Next, okay, 2 power 2 minus 1 is 2 power 1 only. Na? 2 power 1 is 2 only. 3 2s are 6. 6 is a perfect number. Okay, now we can substitute k value 3. K value 3. Then what we are getting? Just here once the 2 power 3. 2 power 3 means how much? 8. 8. 2 power 3 means 2 into 2 into 2. That is 8. 8 minus 1 is 7. Okay, that means 7 is prime number. Then we are getting answer. What we are getting? 2 power 3 minus 1 into 2 power 3 minus 1. That is nothing but what we are getting? 7 into here 2 power 3 minus 1 is 2 power 2. 2 power 2 means 4. That is 7 into 4. 7 4s are how much? 28. 28 is perfect number. Okay. By using prime number definition, we can see another definition. What is that means? Twin primes. Twin primes. Okay. What is meant by twin primes means we have to take a two prime numbers. Two prime number, the difference is 2. That means, for example, I'm taking. Okay, what are the prime numbers means? 2 comma, 3 comma, 5 comma, 7 comma, 11 comma, 13 comma, 17 comma, 19 comma, and so on. Those are all prime number. Okay, here. We are getting a prime number. Okay, we want to take a 2 prime number. For example, I am taking, okay, 3 and 5 or 2 and 3. Okay, if I am taking 2 and 3, difference of these two numbers is 1. Okay, then it is not a twin prime. Okay, what is twin prime? For example, 3 and 5 I am taking. Okay, these two are prime numbers. Difference is 2 or not? Difference is 2. Then it is a twin prime. For example, 5 and 7 we are taking. Okay, prime numbers, difference is 2. Then it is a twin prime. Okay, 7 and 11 we can take. Difference is 4. It is not a twin prime. What is meant by twin prime means we have to take a 2 prime number. The difference is k 2. For example, now we can say 7 comma 9. It is a twin prime. When you take the difference is 2 only, but 9 is not a prime number, then it is not a twin prime. What is meant by twin prime is those two numbers must be prime number and difference must be 2. Just here once the 11 and 13. 11 and 13. 11 and 13 are? Okay. Prime numbers, their difference is 2. Then it is a twin prime. What is meant by twin prime means we have to take a 2 prime number, their difference is 2. Then we can say that this is a twin prime. Okay. Relatively. Primes or are co-primes. Okay. What is meant by relatively prime numbers are co-prime numbers. For example, when we are taking any two numbers. Okay, for example, I am taking 2 and 9 I am taking. 2 and 9. Okay, if I am taking 2 and 9, just what are the factors of 2? What are the factors of 2? 1 and 2. What are the factors of 9? 1 and 3 and 9. What is the common factor for 2 and 9? 1 only. Okay, for example, when I am taking 2 and 8. What are factors of 2 means? 1 and 2. What are factors of 8 means? 1 comma, 2 comma, 4 comma, 8. What are the common factors means? 1 and 2. Okay, for example, I am taking 8 and okay, some 18. Okay, what are the factors of 8 means? Okay, what are factors of 8 means? 2, 4, 8. What are factors of 18 means? 1, 2, 3. Okay, 4 it is not usable. 5 it is not usable. 6 it is usable. Next, 9 it is usable. Next, 18. Okay, these are the factors. What are the factors here means? Okay, 1, 2. Okay, just here once the when you are observing the factors, okay, it contains only one as a common factor. For example, here, only one as a common factor. Here, 1 and 2 are the common factor. Here, 1 and 2 are the common factor. That means, what are the numbers having only common factor 1? Okay, that means, these two numbers having common factor 1. Then these two we can call as relatively prime or co-prime. Okay, 2 and 8, they are not relatively prime or co-prime. Why? Because it contains 1 as a common factor and 2 as a common factor. That means, just here, I'll take another example. For example, 4 comma 9 I am taking. 4 comma 9. 4 comma 9. Okay. One is, what are the factors for 4? Okay. 1, 2, 4. Okay. What are the factors for 9? 1, 3, 9. What is common factor means? Only 1. Then 4 and 9 are? Okay. Co-prime. Just here one of the, what is co-prime definition means? When we are taking any two number, their common factor must be 1. Other than 1, any common factor is there means they are not co-primes. Okay, what is twin prime means? We have to take a 2 prime number, their difference is 2. But here, no need to take the prime numbers. Just here one, so the 4 and 9 are not prime number. But we are getting twin, sorry, co-primes. Okay, here 2 and 9. Here 2 is prime number, 9 is not a prime number. But we are getting co-primes. Okay, what is co-prime means? When we are taking a 2 number, they're having common factor only 1. Other than 1, any common factor it is there means they are not a co-prime. For example, I'll take another example. Okay, 9 and 12. 9 and 12. 9 factors, what are 9 factors means? 1, 3, 9. What are 12 factors means? 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 12. Okay, what are the common factor means? 1 and 3. Then these two are not co-primes. Now we can observe prime factorization of prime factorization. Okay, what is prime factorization? Okay, for example, any composite number they are given. That means, for example, 4 is a number. 4 is composite number or not? Yes, it contains more than 2 factors, then it is a composite number. Every composite number can be written as a product of prime numbers. Product of prime number. That means just here once of the 4 can be written as 2 into 2. Okay. 6 I am taking. 6 can be written as 2 into 3. 6 is a composite number. It can be written as a product of prime number. That means 2 into 3. Okay. Next I am taking 8. 8 can be written as a 2 into 2 into 2. Okay. Product of prime number. 9 I am taking. 9 can be written as 3 into 3. Okay. The same way 10 can be written as 2 into 5. Okay. 12 can be written as a 2 into 2 into 3. Okay. Just here one of the every composite number can be written as a product of prime number. Okay. That product of prime numbers we can call as prime factorization. Okay. How we can find the prime factorization of given number means? Just here one of the, I'll go with a small example. 48. Now we need to observe it is divisible by first prime number or not. Yes, it is divisible by first prime number 2. How many times means? 24 times. Again, it is divisible by any prime number. First prime number or not? Yes, it is divisible by 2. Then it is divisible by 12. Okay, next again it is divisible by 2 or not? 6 times. Okay, again it is divisible by prime number 2 or not? Yes, it is 3 times. Okay, at last we are getting a prime number. Then we can stop there. Then 48 can be written as just here on the 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 3. Here, 2 is multiplied up 4 times, then what we can write means 2 power 4 into 3, that is 48 prime factorization is 2 power 4 into 3. Okay, when we are taking another number, for example, they are given some, okay, 216. Okay, some 216 they are given. Just see answer the 216 is divisible by 2 or not? Yes, it is divisible by 2. How many times means 108 times. Okay, again it is divisible by 2 or not? Yes, it is divisible. How many times means 2 table here? 54 times. Okay, 54 times. Again it is divisible by 2 or not? Yes, it is divisible by 2. Then how many times means here it is 27 times. Okay, next it is divisible by 2 or not? Yes, it is not divisible by 2. Then we can go with the next prime number. What is next prime number? It is divisible by 3 or not? Yes, it is divisible by 3. What is 3 divisibility rule? We know. Okay, how many times? 9 times. Okay, again this is divisible by 3 or not? Okay, yes, it is divisible by 3. How many times? 3 times. Okay, we are getting at last a prime number. You can stop it there. Then 216 can be written as, how we can write? 2 into 2 into 2 into 2. Okay, 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 3 into 3. Just here once the 2 is multiplied 3 times, then we can write 2 power 3 into 3 power 3. Okay, just any number they are given means just we need to check with all the prime numbers division, then after we can write in this form. This is prime factorization of given number. Okay, by using prime factorization we can say so many things after. Okay, for the next session we can discuss some more topics related to prime factorization and factors. Thank you.